So today we'll be getting into the latest with Sasha Banks, John Cena, and Roman Reigns' shot towards The Fiend. Let's start things off with the latest update on John Cena's WWE return. John Cena and his return has been popping up in headlines a lot recently. John Cena has wrapped up his HBO Peacemaker series and may finally have some free time for a WWE appearance. That HBO series is what tied John Cena down for a long time and forced him to miss the first WrestleMania of his entire career this year. But that series has officially wrapped, possibly freeing up Cena's schedule just a bit. The new Fast and the Furious movie is coming out soon and features John Cena as one of the leads, so he may have to do a lot of press for that as well. But there just seems to be this general idea that he could be back real soon. Of course, we went over his comments from a recent interview where he talked about how he wanted the crowds to return and how he was looking forward to returning. Not only did he miss WrestleMania, but this is up there as one of the longest times that he's been away from WWE. He's been fully gone from WWE television for well over a year now. He usually popped in every once in a while, but the pandemic, filming, and everything else made that quite the challenge in recent months. But it appears that we're heading back in the right direction for Cena's return. Reports claim that July 16th is being discussed as a possible return date for John Cena. July 16th will be a very historic episode of SmackDown because it will be the first major WWE televised show to have a live crowd since last March. So chances are that WWE will treat this show as a big deal, and rightfully so because it is a big deal. This will be the first SmackDown episode back on the road with fans, in attendance, and a lot of eyes will be on WWE that night. Everyone will likely stop by that night to check in on SmackDown and see how a crowd looks like on SmackDown once again. WWE is already heavily advertising the July 16th of SmackDown, which is well over a month away, so that's a good indication that they'll have some big things planned for that show. One of those big things possibly being John Cena's return. It'll be the first show back with fans. The energy will be amazing in the arena, so it makes sense to capitalize on that with a big return like John Cena. Remember that when John Cena returned in early 2020, he didn't really get to enjoy the fans because several days after the return in 2020, everything was shut down. He found himself in the Performance Center for SmackDown and filming his WrestleMania match in a warehouse, so it wasn't exactly what he was expecting at all, to say the least. Maybe Cena would have stuck around a bit more in 2020 if it wasn't for all the horrible circumstances. But that's all we got. He was gone after the WrestleMania match. But a return at the WWE comeback show on July 16th would benefit everyone. Cena gets to be back in front of the first crowd back, and WWE can obviously benefit from his return as well. If all those pieces fall into place, July 16th could go down as a special episode of SmackDown. Then from there, maybe it's a one-off appearance from John Cena, or maybe someone comes out and he starts a little program with them. Lots of possibilities there for July 16th SmackDown and John Cena's WWE return, but we'll have to see what happens there. Sasha Banks has quietly disappeared in recent weeks and hasn't competed since WrestleMania. It hasn't been a quiet hiatus because Sasha is one of the massive franchise superstars in WWE. Her absence doesn't go unnoticed. Obviously, with the amount of time that Sasha has been gone for, it's safe to say that this is most definitely a hiatus for Sasha Banks just to rest up and charge up. Of course, Sasha Banks was one of the superstars that took no time off during a hard year like 2020. During one of the toughest years, Sasha was still there every week as Raw's Women's Champion, Tag Team Champion, and SmackDown Women's Champion. She held all those titles and competed on Raw, SmackDown, and NXT all in one year. So yeah, as you can see, Sasha Banks was definitely owed a nice hiatus, just to charge up and rest from how hard she's been working. So no one has a problem with the hiatus. Similar to Bray Wyatt, everyone just wants the superstars to rest, get their mental health in the right place, and get their physical health in place before they even think about returning. But while they're on hiatus, it's still fun to speculate and come up with scenarios for their return. So, what should we expect from Sasha Banks' return? Well, Sasha recently posted a bit of a cryptic tweet that showed an image of herself with the name Sasha Banks written with SmackDown's usual font. So, is that a teaser that she's returning soon, or was it just a cool graphic that she wanted to post? Really could be either or, but the rumor is that Sasha Banks will come back for Bianca Belair. WWE's rematch policy for former champions is a bit of a mess. Some former champions get two or three matches after they lose their title, while some former champions don't even get a single rematch at all. But in Sasha's case, given her stature and everything else, we should definitely expect her to be one of those former champions that gets to do a rematch. A lot of reports claim that WWE didn't want to drain the life out of Banks vs. Belair feud after WrestleMania. That's why Sasha was written off, just to buy some time to pick up the feud when live fans returned. And there's no issue with that plan at all. That's quite smart. We saw what Sasha Banks and Bianca Belair could do at WrestleMania. They really deserve to have their next match in front of another massive crowd. And that's what looks like will happen. With all this talk about July 16th, maybe that'll be a good return date for Sasha Banks to return at as well. First show back on SmackDown with fans, and Sasha Banks returns on that edition of SmackDown, that would make a lot of sense. Maybe return there to attack Bianca and start that build up to another meeting with Bianca Belair at SummerSlam. That would be perfect, and we should expect to see something similar to that for sure. Sasha Banks should return right into the title picture and pick things back up with Bianca Belair. Are you looking forward to Sasha Banks' WWE return? So, we had a big unexpected moment on SmackDown this week, and that was, of course, Paul Heyman name-dropping The Fiend. This was the first time that anyone has really mentioned The Fiend since WrestleMania. This was quite the interesting name-drop. During SmackDown, Paul Heyman praised Roman Reigns' work since returning last summer, and even said that Roman scared The Fiend over to Raw. So a real quick line there, but you know how Paul Heyman is. He'll throw a quick line in there that means nothing in that specific moment, but could have a deeper meaning in the future. That's what this line seems to be. Paul Heyman and Roman Reigns are calling The Fiend out for running over to Raw the second Roman Reigns returned. Obviously, we know the real reason why The Fiend never went after Roman Reigns, and that's because creative just canceled those plans. But speaking strictly storyline-wise, it's a good question to ask. Why didn't The Fiend go after Roman Reigns right away? Roman literally stole the Universal title from him after a 7-day title reign, and The Fiend did nothing about it? We saw Bray Wyatt and Alexa Bliss start to tease the feud with Roman Reigns, but they ended up switching their focus and going over to Raw. So Paul Heyman has every right to drop that line about The Fiend, but could that line come back to haunt Heyman and Roman in the future? Bray's stories are always magical. Roman's stories are on a whole other level right now. It would just be so interesting to see how the two of their stories would combine with one another, especially after that recent shot by Paul Heyman. But is this something that you want to see? Do you want to see The Fiend versus Roman Reigns? Leave your comments. Don't forget to subscribe with all notifications on, and leave a like if you enjoyed. Thanks for watching, guys.